Hi guys, I'm Bridget. When I was a young girl, my dad used to take us on outdoor adventures, hiking, fishing, camping, boating, you name it. We always had a good time and learned something new. He was also a science teacher and encouraged me to write about these experiences. He also taught us the importance of exploring and focusing on the real things. Real things are what's right in front of you. My love for the outdoors has never subsided. In college, I learned to sail in Green Bay, Wisconsin, and appreciated the ability to move the boat forward just by simply capturing the wind's power, tacking back and forth, very patiently. But you also had to pay attention. Sometimes you have to adjust the sails unexpectedly, or otherwise the boat would lose momentum, or you could even capsize. I've capsized before, and the water's really cold. Sailing is tough work, and you have to work as a team. The captain receives a lot of respect, and I was fine being a crew member because each person was critical. For many years in my career, though, it seems I was just a passenger or crew member on someone else's canoe. A canoe is slow, heavy, and unstable, and I was told where to paddle. Many times it was upstream, against the current, or in circles. Nobody was really navigating, and it was hard to sustain long term. Just going along for the ride, it's not working anymore for me. So I'm really passionate about sharing positive stories. So I wrote a book called Real Things and have a website called Real Things. Real Things is about spreading compassion, and that can be contagious. I want to use the Real Things platform to share and highlight a special story on a regular basis, especially those that can make a difference in someone else's life. Others can learn from these stories for inspirational or motivational purposes. For example, my friend Mark shared with me the story about how Big Brother's organization made a big difference in his life. He was recently reacquainted with his Big Brother from the 1960s, and it brought back a flood of positive memories. This moment made him consider what it was and what it could have been. The impact this man had on Mark's life was positive because he had an absent father. Mark learned to fish on a canoe with this man and learned to explore the outdoors with this man's family. Mark is now a vocal advocate of the Big Brothers organization and volunteers to work with boys in need, especially those in need of a good role model. Another example is my brother-in-law. He got a job getting trained by North Georgia of Goodwill. Many people think of Goodwill as just a store to go buy used stuff. They actually provide a lot of training for people who need help. He's now been employed with a good steady job for 5 years. Majority of people are reactionary. They aren't intentional. They just do enough to get by to make it to the end of the day, and then they have to start all over again tomorrow. Nothing changes because they are stuck in the same narrative, and that narrative is usually framed in a negative way. We don't hear enough about the good things happening and what things are working. I want to encourage others to not be afraid to go wander out in the deep waters. It's okay. Work as a team as needed, like on a sailboat. For each individual matters. You matter. You can make a difference. So what do you see working? Are you paddling someone else's canoe? I invite you to share your story with us on Real Things. Come on and join our crew. Follow your passion to make a difference in someone else's life. Thank you so much.